Hey guys, since we launched the last behind the scene video for MGSP2, a lot of you asked in the comments how exactly they would build those crappy LED lights we used to light the entire short. So we decided to shoot this quick video tutorial in which Mattia is gonna explain the process of building them from scratch. Unfortunately, Mattia is not much of the talking type, and last time we shot the behind the scene, it was very hard to get him to talk in front of the camera. So this time around, I'm gonna do all the talking and he's gonna do all the building, which is the way he'd want it to be. I hope you enjoy it. So here we go. Here we have our light and the electric box that we're gonna be showing you later on. The light itself is very common. It's an off-road vehicle, a rooftop light with 9 LEDs. We bought it on an Italian store, but I'm pretty sure you guys can find something very similar on a store near you. We spend like 25 euros for each one of those, so you're not gonna be jeopardizing your savings with these, I'm sure. The very first problem we need to address when using this is that the light, as it is, will not fit on top of your light stands. So we took away the components, the bracket, the bolt, and the nut, and we combine this bracket that Mattia is showing you with the, with another element, which is a metal pipe. This one, which has a 16 millimeters internal diameter, that's very important, you need to remember that. We took this, and on the other side of this, we inserted an M8 nut that we also welded together with the pipe so it doesn't go anywhere. Using these, you can see here is the M8 nut. Using these together with the bolt and the original bracket, you can sort of come up with a light stand adapter, with the Hive division approved light stand adapter, and you need to, as you can see, you need to make this very, very, very tight, because of course you don't use these to pan the lights around on set. You want this to be as tighten as possible. So Mattia's making this very, very, very tight. Okay, now you have your adapter, you can put it together with the light. You take the original bolt, the original nut, and you combine them. At this point, you're gonna be needing a broken washer, as you can see here. You put that broken washer between the light and the bracket. This is very important because it's gonna allow you to tilt the light up and down pretty easily on set, while at the same time the light is not gonna be out of control tilting up and down by itself. So you put the original bolt and you make it pretty tight, but not too tight, because of course if you make it too tight, it's gonna prevent you from tilting the light itself. So Mattia is gonna make this a little tight, just the right amount of energy, and here we go. As you can see, it tilts up and down very, very easily, which is what we wanted. So here we go, this is our adapter. Now we can take care of the electric part. This is a very, very common electric box made of plastic. You can find it literally anywhere. We combined it with HXT connectors so it can work together with the LiPo batteries. We bought these on Hobby King. They're pretty cheap as well. They come with HXT connector and the balancer connector, and you need both of them to have a reliable solution. Now Mattia is gonna show you what's inside this little plastic box. There's not much inside of that, but it's enough for what we needed. You can already see a switch on the lower side. Beside the switch, there is also another little thing that we're going to be showing you. We did, of course, all the necessary holes in this electric box. You can do that with the Dremel. It's very easy. This thing here is a voltage alarm. Also, we bought that on Hobby King. This little thing is gonna tell you when your batteries are running out with those green LEDs. So you can either use this or this other battery checker, which is more sophisticated. Because it's not gonna tell you if the battery is full or half capacity. It's gonna tell you the actual voltage of the battery, which is very, very useful. It's very, very handy if you're into electric stuff, which I'm not. So these are both very reliable ways to manage your battery power. One is more easy to use, the other is more professional, let's say that. Both are perfect for what you need. As you can see, this battery is 75% of its capacity, so enough for us to work with. So now Mattia is gonna put the little checker back inside the electric box, but before he's just gonna show you our very basic setup for the light is already operational. You can attach the HXT connectors together and flip the switch and the light works. So, however, we do not recommend you to use this setup because it's not very... Oh, but you lost your grip. I'm sorry, man. That's cool. Really. That was close. It's very edgy. Mattia's gonna put the alarm checker back in, and that's another hole we did with the Dremel, and Mattia's gonna now close the box. So, I was saying that we do not recommend you to use this setup because lipo batteries are a dangerous business. You don't want them to go below 3.7 volts at any given time because it's both inconvenient for you to, you know, be short on battery on set, and it's also pretty dangerous, so don't do that. Always use a voltage alarm or the battery checker. Here we go, this is our system, 75% capacity of the battery, and the flip is perfectly operational. So this is the combined setup of the electric box, the light, and the battery. One last thing you need to make sure you have is a very simple lock nut that you're gonna be putting at the end of the bolt. That way you will never experience changes in the tilting capacity of the light. It's not gonna become harder than you want it to be, and it's gonna be too soft, and so that means the light is not gonna flip out of control. You need to make this very tight, of course. So here we go. This is our final setup. It tilts up and down very nicely, and now we're gonna prove that the pipe works fine, because here we have a suction grip from Manfrotto. At the end of the suction grip is a spigot, which is the very same piece you can find at the end of any light stand. So we can take our this is the spigot, but yeah, I want to make sure you have all the basics. So now we take our light stand, and as you can see, the pipe fits perfectly on top of the spigot. So now the light is ready to be used on set on top of any light stand you can use. And it's very important that you have that that the pipe is 16 millimeters diameter in order for it to fit on top of a standard light stand. Okay, this is it. I think you guys are now ready to go out and build your own lights, and I hope you enjoy watching this video. Thanks so much, and see you soon on Hive Division.